Foxtrot ground, Foxtrot Mike Victor uniform at Tango 1, requesting taxi to the main apron for run-up.
Mike Victor uniform ground, taxi via Delta.
Taxi Delta to the main apron, Mike Victor uniform.
Welcome everyone.
Tower unit and Tango.
Welcome back. So today... One of the things as a pilot is, not every flight is an epic flight, an epic adventure. Some flights, like today, are just up to the practice area.
1-2, ready for takeoff.
Okay, from now on, nobody call me unless I call you. Break, Indy Tango, report base, clear takeoff, runway 1-2.
Poor guy in the tower. He's doing ground. Doing ground and tower, and he's swamped. Okay, so I'll turn the radio right down. Tower's going nuts. He's got doing tower and ground, and the pattern's full. So not every flight is an epic cross-country adventure. Sometimes, like today, you just need to go to the practice area, and I do this every 6 weeks or so. Go up to the practice area, I practice stalls and slow flight and different emergency procedures, just so that I retain my proficiency. If you're just getting in your plane, you know, every other Saturday and flying somewhere to have a hamburger or, you know, a coffee with friends and flying home and you're not practicing your proficiency at emergency procedures, you're doing yourself a disservice because there are times when you're going to need those emergency procedures. I had an incident maybe about 5 weeks ago and I was so glad that I maintained my proficiency at emergency procedures, and I know this aircraft inside out, very important. So, future video, we're gonna talk about that incident. Everything's fine. Wasn't really much of an incident when it comes right down to it because I knew what to do. So we're gonna go up to the practice area. There is editing. Editing removes context. You're not going to see everything. You're gonna kinda get the highlights. Be assured, I'm doing all of the safety procedures, I'm doing my hazel checks, I'm doing, you know, all of my lookout turns, all of that sort of thing, I'm doing all my radio calls, but you're gonna miss a lot of that, because it just doesn't make for great YouTube. So, make my call, we'll taxi out, and we'll get in the air.
Oshawa ground, Foxtrot, Mike Victor uniform, Cessna 172, with information Foxtrot on the main apron.
Echo Julia Tango Tower, you can turn left crosswind, and you'll be following traffic just over Columbus.
I do it, Tango.
Mike Victor uniform ground.
Mike Victor uniform, Cessna 172 with Foxtrot, requesting taxi to the active for a local north 3500.
Mike Victor uniform ground, runway 12, altimeter 3010, taxi via Alpha Bravo, contact tower holding short, runway 12, and squawk 5331.
Alpha Tower, Golf Bravo, Whiskey Quebec.
Oshawa Tower, Mike Victor uniform, holding short 12 on Bravo, ready to go when able.
Mike Victor uniform, Roger, standby.
Okay, so after 20 minutes of waiting, it's our turn, I think.
Mike Victor uniform, tower, thanks for your patience. Line up and wait, runway 12.
Line up 12, Mike Victor uniform.
Whiskey Lima uniform, tower number 1, departing 1 ahead.
Whiskey Lima uniform.
Mike Victor uniform, tower left, turn out, report 5 north. Clear takeoff, runway 12.
Cleared 12, left turnout, report 5 north, Mike Victor uniform.
Alpha ground, good morning.
Airspeed's alive.
This is call center, Mike Tango on main apron, request taxi clearance to the active. I'm on a VFR flight plan to Wyarton via London at 4,500 feet.
Whiskey Lima uniform, tower cleared to land, runway 12.
Cleared to land, Whiskey Lima uniform.
Mike Victor uniform, tower, change tower frequency.
On route frequency, Mike Victor uniform, thank you.
It's still a little chilly up here. It's only 4 degrees Celsius at 4,000 feet. Last time I was up here in the practice area, I ended up in somebody else's video. It was their first, if I get this correctly, if I remember correctly, it was their first time solo into the practice area. And we communicated a little bit on radio, trying to separate ourselves. Oshawa. Oshawa is a training airport, and as you can see, some mornings the pattern is full and you wait a long time to get out of there. And then they come up here to train. This is where I trained, and there's another training area down by Lake Ontario. And it gets packed, and there are days when I've come up here to do my stalls and slow flight, etc. And you just can't. There's too many aircraft in the box. Which is good, and you should do this. You really should do this. So I've got the training area radio teed up, and I'll start making my calls now.
Okay, so I was in the edit and I realized I didn't probably explain some things as well as I should have. For people first tuning into this channel, what you need to know is that Mike Victor uniform has been extensively changed. It is not a stock 1961-172. We've done an incredible amount of work to the wings and completely changed them. So, first off, from here out on each side, we added 18 inches of wing on each side. So a total of 3 feet of extra wingspan. Almost 13 square feet of extra wing surface. We've also added a sportsman's stole cuff and VGs. Between these three things, we completely changed the flight characteristics of this airplane for slow flight, for stalling, for takeoff roll, for landing roll. All of those things have changed. So the stall speeds you're going to see are going to be quite a bit different than what are in the book. So this plane, stock, out of the factory, clean stall speed with flaps up, 58 miles an hour. Flaps 40 degrees, your stall speed is 51 miles an hour. So bear that in mind with what you're about to see. And as much as I'm practicing my stalls, I'm also taking them all the way to the seat drops out from underneath you point before recovering, just so that I can show you those stall speeds. I think that's important to know exactly where the airplane fails, even though in a regular stall situation, coming in for a landing or whatever, you're never going to let it go that far. You're going to recover long before, or you should recover long before you get into that type of stall. And for people that don't fly and they're wondering what stall is, that is where the wing stops providing lift. When it stops providing lift, it stalls. And so what you've got is a wing coming through the air, and you've got this angle of attack. And so as you increase the angle of attack, as it goes through the air. How do I explain that? You know what? Go back. I've got another video where I explain the stole cuff, the VGs, and the wing extensions. You should go back and take a look at that. I think that'll do you a lot of good. Back into the video.
Lake Scugog training area, this is Cessna 172 Foxtrot Mike Victor uniform. I will be doing some upper air work at 4,000 feet and below in the northeast corner of the training area box, over the northeast arm of Lake Scugog. Any conflicting traffic, please report. Mike Victor uniform.
Okay, so before you do your practice, you have to do your hazel check. I absolutely hate these airplane acronyms. So it's height, altitude, security, engine, and lookout, right? So I'm at a good height, altitude. The area is clear. I'm in the practice area. I'm over a lake. Lots of farmland all around me. Security, doors are shut. Seatbelts are on and tight. Engine, so mixture's rich. Carb heat is off right now, but I just had it on, and the primer's locked. Everything's in the green. Everything looks good. And so I'll do a clearing turn, which is my lookout. So that's either 290s or 1180. I usually do a 180. Made a radio calls as well. That's part of your lookout, letting people know where you are and what you're doing. And there's no one in the practice box this morning, or no one's enunciating themselves in the practice box. Okay, so we're gonna do a clean stall first. power back. Okay, the AOA is in the yellow. Power's back. Speed is up. And there we go. Recovered. I'm gonna have to go back to the tape. Back to the camera to see where that stalled. We got a pretty decent stall break. It looked like it was around 34 miles an hour. And that's clean, no flaps. So the next one I'm gonna do is 20 degrees of flaps, which is sort of a standard landing in this aircraft. So we're at 87 miles an hour. I can deploy my flaps. Back on the power. And there we go. Stall break that time at 29.
Lake Scugog training area, this is Cessna 172 Foxtrot Mike Victory Uniform over the northeast arm of Lake Scugog doing upper air work 4,500 and below. Lake Scugog training area, Foxtrot Mike Victory Uniform.
Okay, everything's in, everything's on, clearing turn was good. 10 degrees of flaps. 20 degrees of flaps. 30 degrees of flaps. 40 degrees of flaps. And here we go, we're pulling back. My very first instructor drilled into me over and over and over again. You hear the stall horn, you recover. You hear the stall horn, you recover. Don't see how far you can push it. You hear the stall horn, you recover. And that should be immediate. I'm gonna do some slow flight. So, carpet's on, mixture's in, mixture's rich. Landing configuration, 10 degrees of flaps, 20 degrees of flaps. So the thing is, 20 degrees of flaps, and I'm at 1,200 RPM, and at 45 miles an hour, I'm losing 200 feet per minute. My AOA is in the yellow. So that's all there is to it. I mean, there really isn't much. You come out, you do your stalls, you do some slow flight, you make sure that you know what's going on with the plane. I recognize that I get a bit of a left wing drop with 40 degrees of flaps just before the stall. I don't like that, but I know how to compensate for it. It's a quirk of this aircraft. It's a quirk of some other Cessna 172s that I've been in as well. You know, make sure you keep the ball centered. Everything's gonna be fine. If you know what you're doing to recover and you practice your recovery often, you're not gonna get caught short when the shit hits the fan. And as we know from, you know, a couple of YouTube channels, the shit hits the fan every day. And I think it's you know, if you're in your airplane flying, you should maintain your proficiency. Not just your recency, not your currency, your proficiency. So I'm gonna head back to Oshawa. That's it for today, just a short one. I got a lot coming up this summer. A lot of flights coming up this summer. We're doing a really long multi-day trip as a fundraiser for a group called Hope Air. Give Hope Wings is the name of the group. I'll leave a link down below. I'm fundraising for them. They're a group that that supports disadvantaged people who can't afford flights to get to medical treatments, especially those people who live in Canada's more remote areas and fly-in communities where the only way to get to a hospital is to, you know, fly. Maybe in the wintertime you could take a skidoo, maybe you could take a boat in the summertime to get to the trailhead to walk to the road. And they pair private pilots to fly people in need to a larger airport where they can get a commercial aircraft and fly. Or you live in some place like the Sioux and you need to get to Toronto for cancer treatment. They support you in that way as well. To this point, the viewers of my cooking YouTube channel have helped raise about $26,000, which is absolutely amazing. I thank them so much for pitching in like that. And so this is the first time I've mentioned it on the airplane channel. And so if this is something that you believe in and you've got a couple of dollars to spare and you want to give to a charity that that actually is out there working and doing good, I'll leave the link below and I thank you very much for your help.
Oshawa Tower, Cessna 172, Foxtrot, Mike Victor Uniform.
Oshawa Mike Victor Uniform, Oshawa Tower.
Oshawa Tower, Mike Victor Uniform is currently at 3,400 feet abeam the town of Uxbridge, inbound for landing.
Mike Victor Uniform Tower, runway 23, wind 220 at 6, altimeter 3012, cleared right base, report entering the control zone, squawk 0051.
Oshawa Tower, Mike Victor Uniform enters the zone.
Mike Victor Uniform, roger. Zulu Sierra Uniform Tower, cleared to land runway 23.
Zulu Sierra Uniform.
Mike Victor Uniform Tower, number 2, follow Cessna half mile final.
Number 2, Cessna in sight, Mike Victor Uniform.
Kilo Romeo Zulu Tower, check you're entering the zone, number 3, following Cessna mid right base.
Kilo Romeo Zulu, number 3, watching for traffic.
Zulu Sierra Uniform Tower, exit right runway 30, contact ground 1184, wow.
Zulu Sierra Uniform.
Mike Victor Uniform Tower, traffic exiting at the intersection, clear to land runway 23.
Clear 23, Mike Victor Uniform.
Oshawa Tower, Kilo Romeo Zulu, can I get an update on my traffic?
Kilo Romeo Zulu, they are just outside half mile final.
Kilo Romeo Zulu.
21 Medevac Tower, there is traffic about 7 southwest of the field, eastbound DA40, 1,800 feet unverified.
We'll look for traffic, 21 Medevac.
Oshawa Towers, Golf Delta Lima Romeo.
Golf Delta Lima Romeo, Oshawa Tower.
Delta Lima Romeo, Diamond Star, presently at 1,700 feet on the shoreline, inbound for landing Oshawa.
Delta Lima Romeo Tower, runway 23, altimeter 3012. And I'm going to have to get you to orbit that current position. There is a medevac inbound. We'll be passing off your right-hand side of Falcon Jet descending through 4,000 feet, landing runway 12 ahead of you.
Delta Lima Romeo, we'll do an orbit.
So that's it for today. We're back at the hangar. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you again soon. Summer flying weather is here, finally.
Oshawa Ground, this is Cessna 172, call for Hotel Zulu Julia with information type.
Call for Hotel Zulu Juliet, Oshawa Ground. I suggest you remain on the apron for now. We'll call you with taxi shortly. There will be medevac jet taxiing in. Keep the entrance clear, please.
We'll keep the entrance clear, Hotel Zulu Julia.